In previous lecture, we discussed about scheduling policies. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about scheduling methodologies. The scheduling methodology was depends upon the type of industry, organization, product, and level of sophistication required. Based on these things, we categorized these scheduling methodologies into three categories. That is charts and boards, and the second one is priority decision rules. Third one is mathematical programming methods. In these charts and boards, we are going to draw the charts and we are going to take the Gantt charts, and based on that Gantt chart, we are going to scheduling that methodology, or we are going to prepare the sequence. Next one is priority decision rules. Based on the entry, we are going to take this priority decision rules. Next, third one is mathematical programming methods. Here, these mathematical programming methods are further classified into a few more categories. Those are all things we are going to discuss in this lecture. First, coming to the chart and boards. In this chart and boards, we are going to take the Gantt charts. Based on that Gantt chart, we are explaining this. Here, the Gantt charts are associated. Scheduling boards have been extensively used in used scheduling devices in the past. Although many the charts are now drawn by using the computers, and we are using some special software to drawing these charts. These are all extremely easy to understand and quickly reveal the current planned situations to all concerned. These are further classified or further named into three more categories. The first, coming to the first one, that is scheduling or progress charts, and which depicts the sequential schedule. First, here I would like to take the example that is I'm going to plot the graph. Here in this graph, in x-axis I'm going to take the jobs, and y-axis I'm going to take the process times. Here we prepared the Gantt chart based on this process time and job. Here, for example, if suppose first job, it requires 6 hours process times, and this is we taken. And for example, if suppose second job is required 4 hours processing time, and if we take another job, that is the third job, it requires 12 hours processing time. Like that, we prepared the chart. This is the Gantt chart. Based on this, we scheduled or we prepared the sequence of that operations. This is one model about scheduling or progress charts, which depicts the sequential schedule. Then coming to the another one, that is the second one in this Gantt charts and boards, that is the load distribution. Here the load was equally distributed, which shows the work assigned to a group of workers. Here, coming to this, here I taken the six machines, and the same I'm going to take the six men or jobs I taken. Here I assigned those machines into the jobs in a one-to-one manner, and equally we distributed the jobs, one job to one mission, like that, where equally we distributed all machines to all jobs. This is about a load chart. Then coming to the third one is a recorded chart, which are used to record the actual operating times and delays of workers and machines. Here we are calculating the operating times of that process, as well as we are calculating the delays of that works. For example, here we are taking the process times and the jobs. Based on this process times and jobs, we are going to calculate the idle time of men and machine, and we are going to calculate the elapsed times. Those are all we calculated in this Gantt charts and boards. This is about Gantt charts and boards. Next, coming to the second methodology, that is priority rules. In that priority rules, we used some priority sequences there. That means we are going to use the entry, that is when the customer is entered, and we are giving the priority to the customers, and we are giving the priority to the jobs, and we are giving the priority to the process times, and we are giving the priority to the material requirement planning. Here we taken some examples of some priority roles we considered here. First, coming to this symbol FCFS, which means first come first serve. Means first come first serve. Here we give the service to the first customer who entered in the first. We will give service to the first customer. For example, if you take the bank, in that bank we are giving the services, we are providing the services to who entered into the queue. In first, we will provide the service to them. And also cinema hall also, we are one example we can take. In the cinema hall queue also, who entered the first, we will give the tickets to that first entered person, or otherwise we are giving service to that first entered person. This is about first come first serve. In a manufacturing also, who are giving the first order, we are giving the first preference to them, and we develop a component and we deliver the component to that first person. That is about the first come first serve. Next, coming to that second one, that is earliest due date, that is EDD, earliest due date. In this earliest due date, the customers was given the due dates to that manufacturer. Based on that due date, we are giving or we are starting the scheduling. For example, if the customers will give the due dates or weeks or month or year, based on this we are going to start that operations. If, for example, if the customer will give the week duration, means we are going to start the earliest due date, that is week duration, we start the first, then we are going to the month, then we are going to the year. Likewise, we are doing the operations in or we are preparing the schedule in this earliest due date. Then coming to the third one, that is least slack. In this least slack, we are giving the importance to that least schedule. That is here the slack means available time minus process time. This is about least slack. From this we are considering the least slack. Which one is the least slack? That one we are giving the first importance or primary importance to that. Okay, this is about slack. Here the time due less processing time we are considering. Next one is SPT, that is the shortest processing time. In the shortest processing time, we are calculating where we consider the shortest processing time. For example, if suppose first job is required 5 hours processing time, and coming to the second job, it requires 6 hours processing time, and third job it requires 2 hours processing time, and fourth job it requires 7 hours processing time. Like that, we are going to take, and from this we choose the minimum processing time. Which one is the minimum processing time? Job three having minimum processing time, that is 2 hours. So first we are going to take the order is 3. So 3, then followed by the next minimum 1, then followed by the next minimum 2, then followed by the next minimum 4. Likewise, we consider the order. This is about shortest processing time. And coming to the next one is, that is longest processing time. Same example we considered for this longest processing time also. From this here, the longest processing time, that is 7 hours are required to job 4. So we are going to take the first, we are going to give the first preference to this job 4, and we are going to give the second preference to job 2, and we are giving the third preference to job 1, and next we are giving the another preference to job 3. So this is the longest processing time. Next, coming to the preferred customer order. For example, the one customer will give 3 orders, and he gave the priority to these 3 orders. The number of priority is first the customer wants third component is first, and the first component is second, then the third component is third. This is the priority of the customers. Based on this priority, we are going to prepare the schedule. So from this, we are first we prepared the job 3, then we prepared the job 1, then we prepared the job 2. This is about preferred customer order. Next, coming to the random selection. So for example, if you have n jobs are there is no due date and there is no preference or priority for that from customer side. So simply we are going to take we are going to pick the orders from in a random manner. First 1, then 4, then 2, then 3, like that we are going to take. So this is the random selection. This is about priority decision rules. Okay, then coming to the third one, that is third scheduling methodology, that is mathematical modeling technique. In the mathematical modeling technique, we are scheduling, we prepare the scheduling based on the two models. Those are linear programming model, and the second one is PET or CPM model. Here in this linear programming model, we considered all the constraints and objectives. We considered, and here the constraints and objectives are formulated into linear equation, and then the problem is solved for optimality. Here for solving this linear equation by using the simplex method and using the transportation methods and assignment models we use to calculate this linear programming models. Then we are coming to the PET and CPM network model was used to calculate the mathematical programming methods. Here the PET and CPM network is the network showing the sequence of operations for the project and the precedence relation between the activities to be completed. Here we are calculating the shortest path of that route, and we are calculating the earliest times, and we are calculating the least processing times. The PET means it is the meaning of PET is project or program evaluation and review technique, and CPM means critical path method. This is about scheduling methodology. And here next we are going to calculate the sequence by using these scheduling methodologies. Here I taken one example for this calculation. Coming to that example, this is the example. Here I taken one bomb squad problem. Here the major thing is that bomb squad was facing a terrible situation. That the number of wish had never happened. A terrorist has planted 5 bombs in an airport building, endangering lives and property. The squad has located all 5 bombs and must now process to dismantle them. Because of limited staffing, the bombs can be dismantled only sequentially. Unfortunately, there is not much time left, and the squad must choose judicially the order in which the bomb will be dismantled. The following data represents a reliable estimated by the squad of what sequence for dismantling the bombs, and would you recommend to the squad what should be the criterion that the squad optimizes. We have to calculate. Simply, I am going to conclude this problem in 2 sentences. Here the problem is we have to give the directions to dismantle the jobs to the bomb squad. The bomb squad never faces the situation, so the reason they are asking or they are wanting the sequence from the expert side. So we are the experts, we are giving the sequence to them. How, which sequence is best to dismantle the jobs, we have to calculate in this problem. So here the given data is bombs, they are given. So the bombs are 5 bombs they considered, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then the time to dismantle hours they mentioned, that is 3 hours, 1 hour, 2 hour, 4 hours and 1 hour. The time remaining before the bomb will be exploded, that is 9 hours, 11.25 hours, 11 hours, 6 hours, 5 hours. These are the exploded times of the bombs. So here we have to calculate the sequence of these dismantled, which job we have to first dismantle, then and then followed by which job we have to dismantle next, we have to calculate here. So for this we are using the scheduling methodology to calculate the sequence. From that scheduling sequence, here I would like to follow the second one, that is the priority rule concept. I'm going to implement here to calculate the sequence. There we have different rules are there, that is first come first serve. Then the second one is shortest processing times, and the third one is least slack, and the fourth one is earliest due date. Like that, we have different types of rules are there. From that rules, here I am going to implement 3 rules. You can use any rule, that is there is no problem. So here, based on the sequence, here I am going to use 3 rules. Those are first come first serve rule I used, and the second one is shortest processing times I used. Then the third one is earliest due date is used. Based on these 3, I concluded the sequence of the dismantled sequence. First, coming to the first come first served rule. In this first come first served rule, I take in the sequence, we take in the sequence based on the problem. The problem itself, they mention the sequence, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the sequence they mentioned in our problem. And also processing times also they mentioned, and expected times also they mentioned. Here, we are going to calculate the flow time and we are going to calculate the late by number of hours. The flow time means here we are going to calculate the total hours, how many hours are required to dismantle all jobs. We calculated this. And here, how much time is, how many bombs are exploded, and why, how many hours was delayed to dismantle that, that was mentioned here in this column. First, coming to this first job, that is bomb one dismantle. So, for the bomb one dismantling process, for the bomb one dismantling process, here the processing time is 3 hours are there. 3 hours are required to dismantle the bomb one. So, and the bomb one will be exploded at 9 hours. So here I am going to calculate the flow time. The flow time is first we started at the 0th hour. So the process 3 hours are required to dismantle the first job. So the total is 3. So here late by number of hours means here there is no late. How we are defining this means here expected time 9 hours is there. After 9 hours the bomb may be explosive. So here we are taking the late by number of hours. So we completed the task the 3 hours itself. So here we have 6 hours time to explode the bomb. So there is no late. So the 6 hours was in the 6 hours time was left. So there is no late. So coming to the same processing time hours for the second one, for the second bomb dismantling, we required 1 hour is required to dismantle the second bomb, and explosive time is 11.2 hours are there. So we started the dismantling of second bomb at 3 hours. So we dismantled the second job by 1 hour. So the total time required for dismantling the second job is 4 hours are there. So late by number of hours is 0. Similarly, we calculated the flow time for third job, fourth job, and fifth job. And here we calculated the late by number of hours for third job, third bomb, and fourth bomb, and fifth bomb. Then after we are calculating the average lateness. The average lateness was here 10 by 5, that is equal to 2 hours. And here the mean flow time is, it is not a means, mean flow time is 6.8 hours. So the total mean time by number of bombs dismantled 5. So 34 by 5 equal to 6.8 hours. This is about first come first serve concept. Here based on the mean flow time, we are going to calculate the sequence. Here the mean time, mean flow time is 6.8 hours. Same similarly, we are going to calculate the mean time for by taking the another sequence. Coming to the next one, next rule. Here I am going to follow the next rule, that is shortest processing time rule. The shortest processing time, flow time late by number of hours calculate every problem ku same anamata. In every problem the process was same for calculating the flow time and late by number of hours. Here the main difference we have to consider is sequence, how we are arranging the sequence, that is the important thing in this priority rules, in the scheduling methodology. Okay, in the previous example, in the previous concept, we taken the first come first serve rule, and accordingly 1-to-1 we are going to take, and who entered the first we give the service to them, like that we considered. But coming to here, the second one is, that is the shortest processing time. Here first we have to consider the process times. Okay, we have to consider the process time. Based on this process time, we are going to arrange the sequence. Here the processing times are mentioned in our problem. There the one is the minimum. So we are going to take the sequence is one is the first. One processing time sequence is first. Then also one is there. So 5, 2, 3. Like that we are going to take. Okay. 3 hours next. 4 hours next. The sequence and based on processing hours we wrote here. Expected time is same for second bomb dismantling. Second bomb explosive 11.25 hours it was given in our problem itself. Fifth one 5, third one 11, 1, 9, fourth 6. Then we are going to calculate the flow time. We started at the 0th hour, and the process time is required, 1 hour is required to dismantle the second job. So second bomb. So sorry, second job dismantling, 1 hour is required. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Likewise, fifth bomb. Total processing hours are 1 hour is required to dismantle. Then we started at first hour, so 2 hours, 4 hours, 7 hours, 11 hours. Same thing, we are going to calculate the late by number of hours also. Okay, and here also we calculated the average lateness. Here the here we have one mistake, I think. See this, fifth job. Oh, sorry, first job. That is the first bomb dismantling. Here the first bomb dismantling, when we started the first bomb dismantling, the first bomb dismantling we started at fourth hour, and the first bomb dismantling required 3 hours time is required. So the total is 7 hours flow time is required. Then coming to this late by number of hours, so here the processing time, the for this 3 hours and expected time is 9 hours are there. But we dismantle it in 7 hours, so there is no late. So simply we are going to take 0. Am I right? So the total average lateness is 5 hours, and the mean flow time is 25. So this is about the shortest processing time. Next we are going to discuss about third one, that is earliest due date. The earliest due date EDD we are going to calculate. Before problem, we considered the processing times to the sequencing, and here coming to this problem, here we are considering the due date. Based on the due date, we are going to scheduling. Here what is the due date? Due date means here we are going to take the explosive time. Explosive time is our due date. The fifth job is early, having 5 hours due date, explosive time. Fourth job 6 hours explosive time. One job 9 hours, 11.2. From the earliest means, based on this earliest time, we are going to write the sequence with help of the blast time. So ikkada first fifth job anedi 5 hours ki blast ayipothundi. So andukani first manam fifth job ni dismantle chestunnam. Second fourth job, like that we are writing based on the expected time. Same again, we are going to calculate the flow time. Again we are going to calculate the late by number of hours. Same average lateness we calculated here. So this is about scheduling methodology, and here we are calculated the different shortest, different routes we calculated, different sequences we calculated. Based on the sequence, we are going to identify which sequence is the better. For that we are taking here comparison table. In this comparison table, we mentioned the routes of all criteria, that is first come first serve, second one is shortest processing time, third one is earliest due date. Here for first come first serve, the total flow time is required 34 hours, and shortest processing time, the flow time is required 25, EDD 35 hours are required. Same coming to the mean flow, 6.8, 5 hours, 7 hours are required. Here average lateness 2 hours, 1 hour, 0. So the sequence to be selected for dismantling is here we considered the total flow time and the mean flow time. The mean flow time, which one is having the minimum, that one we calculated, that sequence is the optimal sequence. So that sequence we followed for further processes. Here shortest processing time, mean flow time is 5 hours are required, so that we selected the shortest route. Shortest processing time sequence we calculated, that is 2, 5, 3, 1, 4. So first we are going to dismantle second bomb, second we are going to dismantle fifth bomb, third we are going to dismantle third one, fourth we are going to dismantle first, fifth we are going to dismantle fourth job. So the bomb spawn may be the selected shortest path timing, shortest processing time criteria to dismantle the bomb, because the mean time of shortest processing time is only 5 hours. And the average lateness is only 1 hour. So based on this concept, they are going to dismantle the jobs.